So just start in the middle of the mat with hands under shoulders, knees under hips. Take the hips over to the left side of the mat and back towards your heels, over to the right and start to make circles. Just make two circles, or three, we'll call it three circles. So move in a way that feels good. As you go, check in with hips, shoulders, neck, wrists, knees, everything else. Once you've done that third one, change the direction. So move in the opposite direction. Again, kind of move in a way that feels good. Pause a little bit here and there. Push a little bit further if that's comfortable. Just kind of seeing what things feel like. So take one more on this side. Hopefully that's roughly got you to about three. And then just make your way back to your hands and knees, just back into the middle of that. Take the hands forward a little bit and tuck the toes under and lift up the knees and push your hips back into down dog. So kind of moving into things a little bit faster than normal. So just take it easy. We'll get back to down dog a couple more times. Just wiggle around and move a little bit. Walk through the feet. Maybe tip the hips side to side just a tiny bit. And then bring the knees back down to the floor. Bring the shoulders forward over the hands and push up through your upper back a little bit. So pressing through your palms. And then relax as you come all the way down to the floor. Stretch the legs back behind you. Arms all the way out in front. Come up onto your fingertips. And press down into the fingertips, tightening the armpits as you lift your chest. And then coming back down, bring the hands back alongside you, the toes under, just press up to hands and knees. Round your back a little bit, so let the head go down, push through the palms, pushing up through the shoulders, and then take the hips back into child's pose, just briefly. For a brief moment, come up onto your fingertips. You can slide the hands forward or back if you need to be comfortable. Let your belly and your chest sink down. And then bring the palms back to the floor and start to ease your way back up into down dog. Let the knees be really bent here. Going to be quite stiff because we're only just moving. And then take small steps as you walk your way forward, coming towards the front of the mat, towards a forward fold. Make sure the knees are bent quite a lot so it's possible to be here while we're still a bit stiff. Bend the knees even more. You can start to lower your hips and roll your way back up to a stand. As you come up, you can roll the shoulders back and the arms can circle out and overhead and bring the hands down in front. So with your palms together in front of you, I'll just take off my jumper. Swivel your right thumb towards you, left thumb away. Stretching the arms out in front. So if you get lost, just take the hands out, turn them upside down, and the left hand goes over the top of the right. And if you go back and forth, you can just keep swapping the hands over. So to have left hand on top, bend the knees a little bit, taking the hands up towards the ceiling, but be comfortable here. So relax the shoulders down. You don't have to be like arms hugging the ears. So somewhere it's easy to be here. With knees bent, tip over a little bit towards your left side. You can let the hips move a little bit right, so you're stretching that right side of the body. Come back up to the middle, you can straighten the legs. Bring the hands back down, and then swivel them to the other side, or just take the right hand on top. Bending the knees, take the hands back up, just to where it's comfortable. Tip over towards the right, letting the hips move a little bit left, stretching that left side. Come back to the middle, letting the legs go straight, bring the hands down. Swivel the other way again. So left arm on top. Take the hands back up, bending the knees. Turn your chest and your head towards the left. And then see if you can swivel your hips back towards the front again. So it moves the twist up through your spine. Come back around to the front, straightening the legs. Bring the hands down. Swivel them back the other way, so end up with right arm on top, taking the arms out, Bend the knee. Turn the head and chest towards your right. Stay there with the upper body and try and twist the hips back towards the front. And then let the upper body come back around, straighten the legs. Bring the hands down. Swivel again. One more time, so you end up with the left arm in front. With this one, just have the hands out in front of you. Bending the knees, stretch the hands and the head forward. So tailbone's tipped under, your back is rounded. Stretch forward a little bit more with the shoulders and the arms and the head. You can push the upper back back a little. And then take the arms up as the legs go straight and lift the heels. A little mini balance on the toes. Bring the heels down. Bring the hands down. And swivel the arms in the opposite direction. End up with right arm on top. Stretch the hands and head forward. Knees bent. Tailbone tips under. So push the upper back back, relax the head, and maybe stretch a tiny bit more through the arms. And then take the arms and the head up, legs go straight, lifting the heels, balance on the toes. Bring the heels down, lower your hands down, and just swivel your palms back together in front of the chest. Relax your hands down at your back. Take your hands behind you, and instead of interlacing the fingers, bring the back of the hands together, so your palms are facing out and just the back of the hands squeeze together. Doesn't matter which arm is which will swap. So you can kind of press the back of the palms together, and that will help you pull elbows and shoulders back. So it should help you stretch through the shoulders and chest. You can lift up the heels to balance on the toes. Keep the heels lifted if possible. And then bend the knees as you sit back to that imaginary chair. Keep sort of pressing the back of the hands together, so elbows and shoulders are back, stretching through the chest. Bring the heels down, keep the knees bent. Let go with the hands, interlacing fingers in front, elbows long. And then push the hands and the head forward, tailbone tips under. And then arms go up towards the ceiling as legs go straight. Lift the heels at the very end, stretch up nice and tall through the hands, and then relax the heels down. Let go with the hands, letting them go out to the sides, fingers up towards the ceiling. So a nice big stretch through your arms. Relax, take the hands behind you again, and this time, so back the hands again together, and try and have the other hand in front. So it should feel a little bit different. So again, kind of think of squeezing the back together, and that will help pull elbows and shoulders back. So again, stretching through the chest and shoulders. So make sure your feet are about hip width apart. Keep squeezing the back of the hands together, elbows, shoulders back. Lift your heels to balance on toes. Bending the knees, sit back to that imaginary chair. See if you can keep the heels lifted, but you don't have to. Let go with the hands, bringing them around in front, interlacing fingers, elbows wide. Push hands and head forward. Tailbone scoops under a little bit, pushing upper back back. If you can, keep the heels lifted. Take the hands and head up as the legs go straight. Stretch up a little bit more. You can get lift higher on your toes, maybe. Then relax the heels down as you let the arms go wide to the sides. Fingers flexed up to the ceiling. And you can pull the armpits down as your hands pass your shoulders. Nice big stretch. When your hands are down, give your shoulders a few circles back and a few circles forward. Just loosening up a little bit. And then come up to the front of the mat if you're not there. Take a breath in as you take the arms up and overhead. And breathe out as the arms go wide. Bend the knees as you go forward, relax through your upper body. With knees bent, lift up halfway as you look forward. Bending back down, step your left foot back to the ledge. Lift the hips up, pushing the front leg kind of straight. Relax the head down. Push through that front big toe and try and push the right butt or right hip back a little bit. So you might even feel that your hips twist a little bit. Relax and bend the front knee, coming back to your lunge. Look forward with your head and chest. Again, relax your head down. Lift up the hips, front leg kind of straight. Push that right hip back a little bit, letting the hips twist a little. And then take your right hand maybe up to the right thigh. So you're twisting your chest towards the right a little bit. And keep pushing that right hip or buttock back. You can even slide your right hand into your right hip crease and push the right hip back a little. But keep pushing into the right foot, front foot on the floor. So it's like the right hip is moving away from the right foot and the right foot is moving away from the hip. Unwind as you come back. Both hands on the floor, looking forward, lifting the head and chest. Then bring both hands to the floor and bring the back knee down to the floor. Bring both hands inside that right leg and wiggle the right foot out to the side a little bit. You can move the hands forward, bending the elbows as you bring hips and groin a little closer to the floor. Push down into the right foot, so really active right leg, bigger stretch in the hips. Move your way back a little bit. And from here, just swing the right leg back to your hands and knees. Then tucking the toes under, lift your knees up, hips up, and push your way back into down dog. Make any adjustments you need to. So move your hands and feet. Find a good distance. Wiggle around and move a little bit. You've opened up through one hip and not the other one, so it's going to feel a little bit uneven on the legs. From down dog, lift up your heels as you round your back, coming forward into plank. Come down to the floor to your belly, however you'd like to go. You can move your hands if you want to, but you don't have to. Squeezing the legs, press the hands into the floor as you lift your chest. Coming back down. Make your way back into down dog. You can move through hands and knees, or you can move through a press up, however it works for you. Walk, step, or jump back up towards the front of the mat, towards that forward fold. Start to bend the knees, lower the hips, roll your way up to the stand. As you come up, you can roll the shoulders back. Arms can make a nice circle, bringing palms together and down in front. Relax the hands down. Easy breath in as you take the arms up. Breathe out as the arms go wide. Bend the knees as you fold forward, going back down. Relaxing the head. With knees bent, you can lift up halfway, look forward. Bending the knees more as you fold down and step the right foot back to the lunge on your other side. Shift the hands back a little bit so you can push the front leg kind of straight. Hips are lifting up, relax your head down. Push into that left foot and keeping the hands on the floor, try to push the left hip back a little bit. So it's going to feel like your foot and your hip are going in opposite directions. Left big toe pushes down, left buttock goes back. So hips almost twist a little bit. It intensifies the stretch. Bending the front knee, come back to that lunge. You can lift your head up, your chest up, take a little bit of pressure out of your hands. Come back down to the lunge. Relaxing the head down, move your hands back a little. Lifting the hips up, so front leg kind of straight. Pushing that left hip back. Take your left hand onto your left thigh. You can stay there, twisting your chest a little to the left. You can even slide the left hand into the left hip to push the left hip back. Still push down through that left big toe. That's more important than the left hip moving. Relax as you bring both hands to the floor. Again, you can lift your head and chest. And then bring the back knee down to the both hands inside that left leg and wiggle the foot out to the left side so you've got some room to move. Bring the hands forward. Start to bend the elbows, lowering hips and groin towards the floor, pressing into that left foot. So nice and strong, a lot of muscle activation in that left leg. Move the hands back a little bit, moving the hips back. And if you just lean to the right, you can swing the left leg back so you come back to your hands feet in the middle of the mat. You can move the hands forward a little bit, tuck the toes under, and press your way back up into down dog. So adjust anything you need to. Move around a little bit. It should feel a little bit more even in the hips, kind of wiggling through things. From down dog, lifting up your heels. Start to round your back as you come forward into plank. Lower down to your belly, however you feel comfortable. Feel free to adjust your arms and hands. Squeeze the legs as you press into your palms to lift your chest. Coming back down. Make your way back into down dog, however you feel comfortable moving there. And then walk, step, or jump back up towards the front of the mat, towards that forward fold. Start to bend the knees, lower your hips, and roll your way to a stand. As you come up, rolling the shoulders back and the arms can circle out and overhead and bring the hands together in front. Bring your hands to your hips. Step your right foot back to a lunge. So you're just going to be on the back toes. That back heel is up. And make sure your chest is lifting up nice and tall. Push that back thigh up a little bit. Take a little breath in as you lift up through the chest. Exhale as you relax a little. And then bring the back heel down to the floor, turning the back toes out a little bit, and the back foot goes flat. Front knees should stay bent and not move very much. Stretch the right arm behind you and the left arm out in front. Push the left leg almost straight. Stretch forward with the left hand and bring the left hand down to the shin. Right hand can come to your hip or go up to the ceiling. So whichever is better here. Push down through that back right heel. And then bending the front knee, your right arm can go back, left arm can go forward. So bring your hands to your hips, front knee should be bent. Really pushing down through that back right leg, squeezing your right buttock and right thigh a little bit. You can lift up through the chest, keep your hands on your hips, and just tip back a little bit. The back right leg is really strong, so the legs don't move, it's just the chest tipping back a few centimeters, really pushing through that right thigh. Come back up to fully upright, lift up the back right heel, and come back onto your toes. So you kind of have to hop a little bit to get the back right heel over the top of those back toes. So you're back to a lunge, facing forward. Step forward to the front of the mat and lift up the right knee to balance. If you need to, you can always touch toes to the floor, but try to keep them up. Interlace fingers underneath that right thigh, letting the elbows bend, and all the weight of the right leg is going to come into your hands. You can relax the head forward, so no strain in the neck. Elbows go wide, stretching through the upper back. If you want a more intense stretch, you can gently press the leg into the hands as the hands resist, but keep it minor. Gently relax, letting the hands come back to the hips. Let the right toes come to the floor. Lift up nice and tall through the chest. And then step the right foot down back alongside the left. So with hands on the hips, step the left foot back to a lunge. So just on the toes, the back heel is up. Lift your chest up nice and tall. Push the back thigh up to the ceiling. As you breathe in, just lift up a little bit through your chest, pushing out through that back thigh. As you exhale, relax a little. And then bring the back left heel in. The left toes turn out a little bit, and the back foot goes flat. Front leg doesn't change. Left arm reaches behind you. Right arm stretches out in front. Make sure your chest is nice and tall. Front leg kind of straight. Reach forward with the right hand down to your shin. The left hand can go up to the ceiling or to your hip, whichever feels better. Be active in the back left heel. So push down through that left heel. Feel like you're kind of squeezing the muscles in the left leg. Bending the right knee, lift your chest back up. Left arm goes back. Right arm goes forward. Bring the hands back to the hips. Front knee should be bent. Really active in the left leg. So squeeze the left buttock, squeeze the left thigh. Hands stay on the hips. Lift up to the chest and tip back just a few centimeters. Really strong back left leg. Come back up with your chest. You're now upright in the chest. Lifting up the back left heel. So you're going to swivel. So you end up with that heel back over your toes, back into a lunge, facing forward, and hips are forward. Step forward to the front of the mat, lifting up the left leg to balance. Remember, toes can touch the floor if you need to. Interlace fingers underneath that left thigh. Bending the elbows, let the weight of the leg go into the hands. So elbows go wide and forward, relaxing the head down. That helps you round the back and stretch across the shoulder. You can gently press the leg into the hands as the hands resist. Shouldn't take much pressure. And then relax, bringing hands back to the hips. Let left toes touch the floor. Lift up tall through your chest. And then step the left foot alongside the right. Relax your hands at your sides. Take a breath in as you take the arms up. Breathe out, letting the arms go long. And bend the knees as you go forward. Relax the head, lift up halfway, knees can be bent, folding back down, walk your way back into down dog, take a few steps to get there, spread out through the fingers, little bend in the elbows, push the hips back a little more, even with the knees bent, then lifting up the heels, start to round your back. Forward into plank. Come down to your belly. Relax the legs. Move the arms if you want to, and then squeeze the legs as you press into the hands to lift your chest. Coming back down. Relax as you tuck toes under. And then squeeze the body a little bit as you push your way back into down dog. Relax your head. Let the knees bend, and then push the hips back, lifting the tailbone. Relax as you bring the knees down to the floor. Just have a seat off to the side, and swing the legs around in front. Take the left leg out straight, and the right foot can be on the floor with right knee bent. Take the right hand behind you. And left hand grabs hold of the knee or even the elbow around the knee to help you twist back to the right. Start to observe your breathing. So notice movement in your belly and chest. If you can, start to relax and slow down a little bit. Gently unwind the twists back to the front. We'll switch over. Right leg out front, bending left knee, left foot on the floor. Left hand goes back, right hand or elbow to the knee as you twist to the left. If it's comfortable, start to breathe through your nose. That'll help you slow down your breath. You can even close your eyes and kind of turn inwards a little bit as you start to slow down more. Unwind the twist, coming back around. Just sit in a cross-legged, comfortable cross-legged position best you can, or any other position that's going to be comfortable for you. Just relax your hands at your side, or you can even have hands on the floor if that's better. Tipping the right ear towards the right shoulder. Stretching through the left side of the neck. If you want to, you can reach left hand or fingers to the floor. Gently tipping your nose to point towards the right knee. And then lifting your head up so you're looking towards your right. Relax, bringing the left hand back. Move it and bring your head forward. Tip left ear towards left shoulder. If you want to, you can reach right hand, fingers to the floor. Tip your nose to point towards the left knee. And then lifting up your head so you're looking a little bit left. Relax as you bring your right hand back and your head around to the front. You can lift up the knees, wiggle forward towards the front of the mat, and come down to lying on your mat. So come all the way down to your back, make sure your head's on the mat. Have knees bent, feet on the floor. Use your feet on the floor to shift your hips to the right, taking left leg straight down the mat, and right knee lifts up and twists over to the left side. You can move your arms wherever it's comfortable. So again, breathing through the nose if that's comfortable. Maybe the eyes are closed. Taking a little breath into the belly or chest. As you exhale, the twist might go a tiny bit deeper, or maybe you just relax into it. And then unwinding, come back around. Use the feet on the floor to move the hips to the left side. Right leg goes straight. Lift up left knee as it twists over to the right. Again, arms wherever it's comfortable. Maybe moving into the twist a little bit with your breath. So when you inhale, just noticing subtle breath into the belly or chest. As you exhale, just on a natural exhale, maybe the twist goes a little bit deeper. Or maybe you just relax a little bit more. And then coming back to the middle, using both feet on the floor to bring your hips back into the middle of the mat. So your spine is in a straight line. Bring both knees into the chest. With hands on your knees, just give them a little bit of a hug to release the back. Pull the knees wide, pulling them towards your arms. And then relax the feet down to the floor and find a comfortable position for Shavasana. So that could be legs down the length of the mat, or knees bent, feet on the floor. Arms can be at your side or on your belly. Come back to focusing on your breath. Let your belly be loose and soft. keeping the focus on your breath. As you breathe in, observe where you see the movement in your belly or your chest. As you breathe out, start to stretch the arms overhead, letting the belly sink down and deflate. And then taking a few breaths here to find a big stretch from fingers to toes, squeezing the muscles, feeling the difference in your belly as you stretch and breathe. And then relaxing, you can bend the arms, bend the knees, and roll to your side. Using the hands on the floor, start to press your way up to a comfortable seated position. As you breathe in, lift up through your spine. As you breathe out, tip forward, relaxing the head and the neck and the back. Maybe the hands come onto the floor in front of you. Opening your eyes and slowly making your way back up. Kia ora, guys. Have a great Friday. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you next week.